Amazing what old chaps and chabbits game chap and bird here.
Yes.
Yes, indeed, fellows, and I dare say we are now investigating here some rather interesting and in some cases quite handy outstanding bugs in the latest version of Minecraft. Now, these have yet to be fixed by Mojang, you know.
Most certainly, some very interesting bugs to open your lugs. And the thing is, do we want to keep some of them? We don't know. We'll have to go and look and see.
And will Microsoft fix them, old chap?
Well, exactly.
Good question, Lewis. Let's go.
Yes, let's go and have a look.
Now, firstly, fellows, look here. In survival mode, we're going to show you a bug to do with mining.
Yes, now over here to this block that I've placed down. This block of bricks.
Oh, did you splash out on that, old chap?
Yes, now.
Very flashy.
Now, start mining that with your sword. This is bug number one.
Bug number one. As you can see, using a sword to mine blocks like so is, of course, very slow normally. But if you block with your sword in mid-mine, as you can see there, you can take your hand off of the mining button and the sprawling progress is saved, old chap. Look at that.
Yes, indeed. I can see it. Yes, the mining process, as you say, is stuck.
As long as you hold down the block button, you can actually keep the mining progress and come back to it like so and carry on mining.
Aha! So, you're not supposed to mine with a sword anyway, but what does it also work with a pickaxe?
No, it doesn't, because you can't block with one. But if you take your mouse cursor away from the block like so, no, you keep the progress! Look at that, old chap!
My word, look at this!
Changing to F5 mode, no, you keep your progress! Look at that, old chap!
Right, some bug that is... Right, okay, now, let's go and have a look at the next one!
That's quite a big bug! Now, this next bug is a very handy one, I tell you. Now, for this, you're going to need a doggy or no?
Most certainly! Yes, it is! Now, watch through these bugs and see which ones you think you would like to keep in the game, perhaps.
Well, indeed, I see. As you can see, we have here, oh, there's Scott, our famous and proud doggy, you know.
Yes,
of course,
one dog.
This doggy in the newest versions of Minecraft will actually automatically hunt down skeletons for you.
Automatic hunting of skellies. Right, let's see if it works then.
No, that's a feature, old chap. But the bug or the glitch is, of course, an extension of that feature. To show you this, we have to go to a cave wherein we will see exactly what that doggy starts to do.
Right, so they automatically hunt skellies anyway, but what do they do now in this bug thing?
Indeed, old boy. Now, as you can see, we've just arrived in a mine of sorts. There's a zombie. Now, of course, the doggy who should be close by. Where is he, I say?
I don't know. He's not following you, unfortunately.
So anyway, they don't teleport now, but moving on, as you can see, we're going to go into the mines. Now, of course, normally it's rather tough in mines to find caves and things containing precious ores, etc. and so forth.
Yes, yes, yes.
But if we go into this mine like so, I want you to watch Scott's behaviour quite closely. Now, observe, fellows. In this room somewhere is a skeleton hiding.
But behind the wall.
Where is he?
Right.
We don't know. But of course, I tell you this, Scott knows. Hold on. And there he goes.
Ooh,
yes,
he
indeed.
Knows.
He knows where that skeleton is. As you can see, he's gone straight over to him. Good boy, game, I say. Well done, my good lad. There we are.
Aha.
Who's a good boy, I say. So, as you can see, he found the skeleton behind the wall, of course. There's a treat for you, I say. Now, of course, this can be further used inside mines, because if a skeleton happens to spawn nearby in a cave that's close by, the doggy will, of course, home straight in on that skeleton and basically tell you where the cave is.
Aha!
I must say, it does indeed seem the dogs have taken a bit of an intelligence nerf. They won't teleport to you, etc. and so forth. But anyway, have a look inside this room, fellows. Can you guess where that skeleton is, Isaac?
Yes, okay, so he's in here somewhere. We've planted him. Now let's see if he does it again, if it wasn't just a fluke.
He's around here somewhere. Go on, Scott, find the skeleton. Go on, old chap. There he goes. Yes, indeed. He knows where to go.
Yes, he does.
It was where the leash was, as you can see. Get him, my boy. In there you go. Good sir. Yes, indeed, Isaac.
Right.
Well done.
Yes, indeed. So this is rather fun, isn't it? It's a very useful thing. You can find caves of all sorts.
Yes, indeed, Isaac. Now, of course, the trick is if you go to a mine where there are caves, the dog will automatically home in on the skeletons and, of course, show you any hidden caves as a result. It's very clever.
It most certainly is, yes, indeed. So what else do we have?
Now, Frills, this brings us to these chaps, the Iron Giants, you know. These, of course, they had a bit of a problem and a bit of dispute with creepers the other day. And, of course, what the Mojang chaps did is they coded them so that creepers would attack them or vice versa, thus resulting in your village getting blown up.
Yes, it was a problem, wasn't it?
It was a big problem. Now, they said we've actually fixed this bug, so golems will no longer attack creepers and the other way around. But, I say, it seems the bug is still here, you know.
Are you sure?
I'm quite sure. As you can see, normally, there's a creeper, there's a golem. The creeper's not interested in the golem, as you can see, because it's, so say, been fixed.
Yes.
But if we spawn a creeper right nearby to a golem, like so,
right,
get him just up close, I say, it's hard sometimes. It's a bit of temperamental touch and go, but fluky, I say.
Yes.
But if he's right next to him and you just get the timing just right, there you go!
Oh, yes,
indeed, I say. Oh, yes, and he's got a rampage now. Chap's getting mad, you know.
No, that one's upset him. He's doing them all now.
Of course.
It looks to me as though they haven't 100% fixed this. They fixed it a bit.
They've fixed it a bit. As you can see, they're still blowing up there. There you go.
Bye-bye, village, then.
Bye-bye, village. It's not 100% patched. They're going to have to go back to the drawing board.
So when they get all closey and close, that's it. They go mad.
Yes, indeed, I say.
Now, this one's rather interesting because it involves the field of view.
And sprinting. As you can see, let's go to the stables and get our horse.
Right.
Oh, Klopstra, he's not here. Never mind.
Never mind.
As you can see, we'll climb on this horse like so.
Yes.
Now, of course, I want you to observe what the horse he does.
Right.
Normally, when I'm riding around, of course, I get a standard view in first-person mode.
You do.
Now, of course, as you know, you can hold down control to sprint.
Yes,
if I hold down sprint key while on the horseback, though, like so, my field of view changes. Did you see that? But my speed doesn't actually go any faster.
Aha! So, when you try to move him faster, it doesn't actually go faster, your field of view changes.
Yes, the game thinks you're going faster, but actually, you're not going faster. Like you can see there, the field of view changed to simulate increased speed, but of course it's not the case. Now let's go to the riverside, old boy, where you'll see the same thing happens with other vehicles.
Right, okay.
Boat, wait, there's more!
Ah, yes indeed.
As you will see, climb into your boat like so, sail off on the horizon. Now, of course, holding down control to sprint once more changes our FOV, and our boat speed does not increase.
Aha! So this is a way to change your FOV slightly, that should really happen.
I believe it's termed as a bug.
I think it is. Bugs!
We're in the clouds now, as you can see.
In the clouds? Hang on, where are we?
We've got a head start, old chap.
Have we?
Oh, yes. Yeah. Now, as you can see, here's a big chest, I say. Now, inside this big chest is nothing, because I want to show you instead a bug. As you can see, when breaking the chest like so, as you can see, the chest cracks and gives off particles indicating it's being broken.
It does,
now,
yes.
The same also happens when I try to break these hair blocks or wool blocks here, as you can see, both breaking and particle animations.
Yep.
However, if I choose to break a signpost, for example, like this one, as you can see, the signpost indicates that it's breaking, but no particles are actually given off until you break it.
Hang on a minute, I've just had a thought.
What?
Maybe that shouldn't be a bug, maybe it should actually be like that, because if you think about it, if you hit something like that, it doesn't actually splinter until it breaks.
But as you can see, the chests do splinter before they're broken.
Yes, but should we have those splinters? Perhaps those splinters are bugs.
No, they've been part of Minecraft for yonks, old chap.
Yes, but surely it doesn't really splinter until it breaks.
And yes, it does work on this one, as you can see.
Oh yes, try this one too.
Yeah, but really, old chap, come on, old boy.
Ah, look at that. So do you want particles when you're hitting or not? Yes or no, yes or no, yes or no!
Now, next, I see, this bug involves fire fennels. This is quite an amusing one, as you can see.
Is that Netherrack?
It's Netherrack,
I'm sure. I didn't know this. It's the thing.
Yes, let's set this all on fire, this whole area, like so.
Now, what
we're going to do, of course, is use our water bucket to extinguish some of this fire and listen and watch to the particle effects it makes.
Right.
Listen.
Go on.
It's Buddy Wool, old chap!
Wait a minute, it's wool!
Yes, indeed. Of course, the sound and effect it made there, as you could see, to just get rid of this water, was, of course, that of wool. Let's try once more over here, so we can double confirm that, I say. On fire goes the grime, like so,
and
watch closer.
Yes.
What do you know? There you go, Elchap. It actually gives off particles and makes a sound like a block of wool being broken. That doesn't make any sense.
Excuse me, I don't think old Bill's going to be very happy about all these bugs, do you?
Fire doesn't sound like wool, old boy.
Oh, summons for the shop.
Now, this next bug is a redstone bug involving daylight sensors.
Right, where are we?
We're here. Well, anyway, of course, as you can see, if we place down a regular daylight sensor, it would, of course, give off a redstone current in the day. That's nothing new, though. They're supposed to do that. If we encase the daylight sensor inside a solid room like so on all sides, which means there's absolutely no... But go away, old chap! Sunlight getting through. Excuse me, I can't place the block down. There you are. Now, of course, let's place a little bit of light inside so we can see what we're doing, like so.
Right.
Now, inside here, of course, there is no daylight. So when we place down the daylight sensor, of course, we don't get a signal, you see, like that.
That's correct,
because it can't see the sun.
Right.
However, if we now change the time to night inside this encased room, as you can see here, like so, to, let's say, to 16,000, there
we
are.
Right, yes.
It starts to give off a bad signal, old chap. What's going on there?
Hang on, I'll prove it by knocking the... Look, it's night outside. Have a look.
Ah, it's night outside, as you can see. There's the moon. Now, of course, place the block back, though, and therefore shut it off from outside, and the signal comes on again.
This is an extremely confused light sensor block, I think.
Yes, break that block again, old chap.
I will do. There we are. Look.
And its battery stopped. How strange is that, Fennels? Now, of course, although this is a redstone bug, it may have some practical applications, because if you hide daylight sensors indoors, you can abuse this to turn them on and off at nighttime.
Yes, I suppose you could. Yes, that's one thing you could do, and you could also get very confused as to how they work. But never mind.
It might be patched, though, Fennels, so watch out if you do use it. No promises, I say.
Ooh.
Next up is a visual bug, as you can see here.
A visual bug.
Up, in first-person mode, as you can see, and third-person mode, the item position on the hand is perfectly normal. But if you'll sneak, like so, it's halfway up my arm, you'll say.
What?
What's going on there?
Go back to normal.
There's normal. Ah. It's being held clearly inside my gloved hand, as you can see. But when I sneak like so, I'm a robot, you know.
Yes, look at the melon, look.
What's the melon now,
Jeff? Look, watch the melon.
Go on then. Oh, it's off.
What's that? What's
going on now?
Who holds a melon there?
This is bloody absurd. Can we stop twerking now, please, old chap?
My goodness.
Now, this next bug pertains to mob loot drops, as you can see. Uh-huh. We're going to turn them off like so with our game rule update. That means that regular mobs will no longer drop loot. As you can see, for example, these chickens over here won't drop us ice. Hey, would you mind, sir?
Yes.
They won't drop us, of course, their items any longer. Now, this goes also for hostile mobs, but Bertie, we need to see an ender dragon here right now, old chap.
An ender dragon? I can't see any.
No, we've got a spawn on it, old boy. This is very safe. Don't worry, Penel, it's all fully tested, I can assure you.
Right,
that's your line, old chap. Let's spawn in the end dragon, as you can see. And we're going to slay him with our special sword. Now, watch closely, as you can see. Hold on, Penel, you have to wait for this one, I say. When he dies, he will, of course, just a moment, his mob loot drops. Hold on. There they come, old chap. Yes, indeed, I say. He's dropping experience, which he bloody well should be, you know.
So you've got it turned off, but they're still dropping.
That's right. He dropped experience orbs there for us, as you can see. And apparently it has been tested that with the mob loot rule turned on, he will drop roughly half what he does when it's turned off. So there is some attempt to, shall we say, turn his drops off, but it doesn't quite fully work.
Would you think they're trying to nerf him in some way?
No, I don't think so, but I think it's a bug, because, of course, that rule is supposed to turn off all mob drops, not just half of them.
Aha! So bugs!
Yes, indeed, I say.
So loads of bugs, some of which could be useful. Which ones do you think are useful? Shall we recap them again?
Yes, oh my, good idea. And as you can see there, you can take your hand off of the mining button, and the sprawling progress is saved, old chap. Look at that.
Yes, indeed, I can see it. Yes, the mining process, as you say, is stuck.
Scott knows. Hold on. And there he goes.
Oh,
yes,
he
indeed.
Knows.
He knows where that Skangdon is, as you can see. He's gone straight over to him. Good boy, game, I say. And you just get the timing just right. There you go.
Oh, yes
indeed, I say. Oh, yes, and he's gone on a rampage, old chap. He's going mad, you know.
That one's upset him. He's doing them all now. So, when you try to move him faster, it doesn't actually go faster. Your field of view changes.
Yes, the game thinks you're going faster, but actually, you're not going faster. Like you can see there, the field of view changed to simulate increased speed, but of course it's not the case.
Oh, yes, try this one too.
Yeah, but really, old chap, come on, old boy.
Ah, look at that. So do you want particles when you're hitting or not? Yes or no, yes or no, yes or no?
On fire goes the grind like so,
yes,
and
yes.
Watch closer.
Yes.
What do you know? There you go, Elchap. It actually gives off particles and makes a sound like a block of wool being broken. If we now change the time to night inside this encased room, as you can see here, like so, to, let's say to 16,000, there
right,
we are.
Yes.
It starts to give off a bloody signal, Elchap. What's going on there?
Hang on, I'll prove it by knocking the... Look, it's night outside. Have a look.
Ah, it's night outside, as you can see. There's the moon. But when I sneak like so, I'm a robot, you know.
Yes, look at the melon, look.
What's the melon now,
Jeff? Look, watch the melon.
Go on then. Oh, it's
off. Look at this. What's that?
Hang on now. My word, Fails, what an interesting collection. I do hope the chaps fix these at Microsoft or otherwise.
It is, you can get the Ender Dragon. He still drops his drops, Mr. Mayor. Am I sure? Yes, I'll show you. Look,
not in here, old chap. Not in the Ender Dragon. You can't spawn inside the mayor's eyes, old
man. It was a knee-jerk thing. I thought Mr. Mayor would kill it. Mr. Mayor, evacuate and kill it, quick.
Come back here, you bad dragon. Leave that statue alone. For goodness sakes. We look forward to seeing you again, everybody else I see. I shall stay. You'll come back.
Ooh, that's going to bug Mr. Mayor.